Classic Poems for Girls, read by Laura Paton, Roy McMillan, Anne-Marie Piazza, and Benjamin Soames.
The Lobster Quadrille by Lewis Carroll. "Will you walk a little faster?" said a whiting to a snail. "There's a porpoise close behind us, and he's treading on my tail. See how eagerly the lobsters and the turtles all advance. They are waiting on the shingle. Will you come and join the dance? Will you, won't you, will you, won't you, will you join the dance? Will you, won't you, will you, won't you, won't you join the dance? You can really have no notion how delightful it will be when they take us up and throw us with the lobsters out to sea." But the snail replied, "Too far, too far," and gave a look askance, said he thanked the whiting kindly, but he would not join the dance. "Would not, could not, would not, could not, would not join the dance. Would not, could not, would not, could not, could not join the dance." "What matters it how far we go?" his scaly friend replied. "There is another shore, you know, upon the other side. The further off from England, the nearer is to France." "Then turn not pale, beloved snail, but come and join the dance. Will you, won't you, will you, won't you, will you join the dance? Will you, won't you, will you, won't you, won't you join the dance?" To the Looking Glass World It Was Alice That Said, by Lewis Carroll. To the looking glass world it was Alice that said, "I've a sceptre in hand, I've a crown on my head. Let the looking glass creatures, whatever they be, come dine with the Red Queen, the White Queen, and me. Then fill up the glasses as quick as you can, and sprinkle the table with buttons and bran. Put cats in the coffee and mice in the tea, and welcome Queen Alice with 30 times 3. "O looking glass creatures," quoth Alice, "draw near. 'Tis an honour to see me, a favour to hear. 'Tis a privilege high to have dinner and tea, along with the Red Queen, the White Queen, and me. Then fill up the glasses with treacle and ink, or anything else that is pleasant to drink. Mix sand with the cider and wool with the wine, and welcome Queen Alice with 90 times 9.
How Doth the Little Crocodile, by Lewis Carroll. How doth the little crocodile improve his shining tail, and pour the waters of the Nile on every golden scale? How cheerfully he seems to grin! How neatly spreads his claws, and welcomes little fishes in with gently smiling jaws. The Owl and the Pussycat, by Edward Lear. The Owl and the Pussycat went to sea in a beautiful pea-green boat. They took some honey and plenty of money wrapped up in a 5-pound note. The Owl looked up to the stars above and sang to a small guitar, "O lovely pussy, O pussy my love, what a beautiful pussy you are, you are, you are, what a beautiful pussy you are." Pussy said to the Owl, "You elegant fowl, how charmingly sweet you sing, O let us be married, too long we have tarried, but what shall we do for a ring?" They sailed away for a year and a day to the land where the bong tree grows, and there in a wood a piggywig stood with a ring at the end of his nose, his nose, his nose, with a ring at the end of his nose. "Dear pig, are you willing to sell for 1 shilling your ring?" said the piggy, "I will." So they took it away and were married next day by the turkey who lives on the hill. They dined on mince and slices of quince, which they ate.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.